which is making me really nervous.
Oh, I should turn off the fan, she can die. Hi, I'm Colette. I'm calling this channel Miss Poppins because I'm a first time teacher and I want to teach kids to love learning and have a wonder about life and learning like Mary Poppins did in the movies. I got hired in March, I think, and I interviewed in February, and I'm going to be teaching kindergarten and first grade at a private Christian school that this is their first year starting. So over the summer, I've been having meetings with my coworkers where everyone asks about 1.5 million questions, and we get about half of those answered, and then that brings up about another slew of questions. And I've been doing training. My training is on Classical U, or Classical Academic Press, which is an online training center that they paid for me to have. It's really good, it's really insightful. It's taught me a lot. It's good to just have professionals speaking into me as being very not professional. Today, I wrote my welcome letter. Often when I'm talking to little kids, the easiest way, especially if they're shy, is to compliment something they're wearing or ask about like something that seems to be one of their interests. Like, oh, do you like dinosaurs? What's your favorite animal? Is pink your favorite color? And so my letter says, hello, kindergartner, first grader. My name is Miss Poppins, and I'm excited to be your teacher this year. We're going to have a lot of fun learning about good, true, and beautiful things and becoming more like our King Jesus. Here are a couple of my favorite things so you know some things about me. My favorite color, yellow. My favorite food, pizza and burritos. My favorite animal, elephant. My favorite movie, Up. I love my family and my puppy, Pippin. I'm looking forward to meeting you and learning all of your favorite things. Love, Miss Poppins. It was actually a lot of fun to write. I was a little bit intimidated by it, but I literally just typed into Google kindergarten and first grade welcome letter, and it came up with some really cute examples. This afternoon, I'm going to be going to the library to read a lot of kids' books. They've given me a lot of freedom with the literature English curriculum, and they said, oh, here's a list of our recommended books. So I created kind of a preliminary list of kindergarten, first grade books based on their list, and I'm going to go to the library and read a lot of children's books, see if those ones I wrote down still hold up, see if I want to add anything else, just to kind of get an idea again. I will see you there. My mom said earlier that I have the best job ever, and that like, my assignment today is to read children's books, and she's totally right. I just found Angelina Ballerina, which I have not thought about in no idea how long, but it made me really happy to find it today. And that might kind of just be reading some of these for fun, but it's also educational for me. Thank you. So, the end of the matter is, I went to the library, I wrote my welcome letter, and I am still going to do a little bit of training. I found out that, as far as I can tell, things like The Boxcar Children, the first one, and Little House in the Big Woods are quite appropriate for a first grader because it's written in a really simple style and from the perspective of a little kid who's about the same age, if not younger than them. So I think I'm gonna put that on my book list. It is so hot today. I feel like I'm melting. But it's satisfying. It's good work. Thanks. I'll see you later.